like to introduce the new social students.
Did the PhD in the Complutense in I've been working at CSIC. He had several other positions. So he has been working in this diseases, and I hope that this is the part where we are going to collaborate.
Javier, and thank you very much to the Institute. I was bringing a presentation just to send the link of the Institute. They phoned me back. What you are doing there. So. Your director and with other people this morning. Probably with that overview of you can find ways of or new very interested in things related to big data. Doesn't know what is longitudinal studies because I have the same discussion. Just talking that it was quite and in that group of people that on that, but we need to change the name to the kind of data that we have. We can create we can follow longitude a profound transformation of the statistical. Be any more a census. It will be based on the use of big data, mostly the problem that we have is that they know how to deal with longitudinal data. We don't have that many. And we don't have a very to be the ones who will be in the public administration. We need to have from your area, you know very well. About that, but in the more and we need to have two large census of of a census when asked that this is US. Just to give you an example, the 2001 75,000 people just to collect this data. A little bit more than the budget for people to type the data. Statistics. Then the development of computers. Allow us to move all these databases, to move to which was in the past an important problem is individuals and in the past just to have with that. But the problem that we have that we need to train research that and use these new sources of public, and they need to create a for the citizen. It needs to create in other countries like in UK, they are. They are more advanced than we are in this area to make it available for public sector. Has not yet understand a basic infrastructure of the state. This is crucial for our future. Recently discussed in the European Parliament, problems for individual level about that because this has not. Very present in other countries. And other statistical agencies are at a marginal cost because the data is United Nations and other are creating working groups on big use to understand the methods, techniques, analysis. There are some side is one very important plan. Because in social science and very concerned about the of the variables, so we need to have and it's the same kind of data problems that we can face. The second risk is companies, mobile phones. Imagine that the technology. Then what we will have is a discontinuity on our phone companies. And the other thing is producing their own data means that they control what they are combining whenever they are producing the price index that they have. But whenever they are asking Telefónica, control over the generation. They don't know what, how it has been to the statistical officers. They have a growing demand from the public that they need to give them. It's like newspapers. They need to have a headline every 3 hours. So that is coming as well to the National Institute of Statistics. So you need to produce, to have a statistical product quickly. And you need to have it more detailed. And then with a greater desegregation in which you have those databases that you can just produce the information at this fast and with this this quality. We have been changing as well in other areas. This is, for example, mobility, how we were measuring traffic in the past and right now. So it was just to give an example of some of the Ramascos. So how censuses, for example, has been done in the past. The traditional census, the one that is just sending by many countries. There has been census or administrative registers and use the data without doing the operation. And right now, a kind of from the Central Population Register by and it will use the padrón and all the register in 2000 population. By 2021, there will be no sample at all, and all registers and other kind of registers, I think, registers and so on, to try to produce the census. There has been a long tradition of creating these longitudinal databases. I will go this, but there are tradition of linking data from historical demography, linking data from mid-18th century until 19th century and beyond. And you will think, wait, what have historical data in here? You are not aware is whenever you are thinking on statistics between generations through time. Longitudinal register is that normally the window of observation or a maximum in the case of the Swedish from 1968 onwards or the following population. Area that you are looking is quite a lifespan of an individual. You don't have more an interest of linking this longitudinal register to have information of and as well for university, they did a demographic database for Sweden between mid data that is actual data that it has been used. Lund University that is doing a similar thing. They have a statistic Sweden, they have the population. Cambridge University, they did longitudinal studies more based more on health. Second half of the 20th century, the White Hall is one of the very good in the US, and the UK, they have been very keen on doing longitudinal. The one of the most famous longitudinal following 1% of the population in cohort. And the of our project, they are following 5% of the population of Scotland. And they are linking now, they are doing a project which is very interesting on digitizing Scotland, where they are going to link all this information back until 1858. So they will follow the population, all this population from 1858 onwards. Yeah.
When you say follow, which information do you follow from each?
I will give you some examples now with some of the projects that we are doing in Madrid, so you will be able to see the detail. They needed to move to have a longitudinal around 26% of the population didn't answer the census. 1981 and 1991, the parliament didn't approve the law to produce the census. That they needed to have. Samples like the historical sample of the Netherlands, 12 onwards, that gives the possibility. Is a collaboration between biomedical data with biomedical data biobanks. The life of the individuals in this case for most of the 20th century. The Canadian longitudinal study, this is Canada, and similar to that. There are other ones I'm not going to. The Danish twin registry, this has been used pretty much for measuring in this discussion about longevity that is now in journals like Nature and so on. They have been the different twins and so on. Well, and what we follow. This is a Lexis diagram. Individuals, and here you have the calendar time. Each individual. So what we do here is just to the resources that we have. So in this case, we have a change of residence. Here is a marriage, baby. And in this case, this person has that. And migrate to another place. Level information, where we link all the biographies. And these biographies we can follow through. We can pinpoint where these people are in each moment. Or in diffusion of infectious diseases. Why this is linking different statistical sources, you improve the quality information that you are missing in one of the sources, you will. You are crossing variables, you are introducing new variables are not present in the questionnaire. You are adding more possibilities for of for example health labor history or interrelationship between the and this is the way in which we'll and later on in the rest of the world we'll create the possibility of products. And for the statistical offices, it will be very easy to perform census whenever you want because you will have the system link. So actually, you can produce the. And you will have a new family of longitudinal statistical products with information on social space, casual-temporal relationships, and so on. So projects. We are working on different projects. One is called ISDIMAP, the Population Register of the City of Madrid. And the spatial data infrastructure, what is some period of time we have geocoded the we are attaching statistical information. Traffic database of Madrid is including the listing of inhabitants. So all of this has postal and that is the data that this data has been digitized their listing of inhabitants, the information to have a database around 500,000 death records, individual Madrid between 1990 to 1935, which is sources, and we are getting the characteristic of the child. And we have information that is we are creating a database with that. Inhabitants, an index reference to the household. Name, occupation and other information and relationship, kinship relationship, place and date of household and postal address that you have over there. Name, age, marital status. There are things from the civil register and this is the civil register of Madrid. Birthplace and migration. There is a spatial data, spatial information that is combined through the postal address with the demographic data sets. The I will show you the platform. We are interested in individual level data for influenza in pandemic that it took place in 1889. We are organizing now with the National Institute of Health of the US. And you can produce in Madrid, but you can go with that. The other project, briefly, the structure. Oh, okay. What you have here, this is Madrid. You can just choose the maps that you want. In the 1920s, compared with actual photography or catastrophe. And then you have and here what we have done is have you coded all the streets, all the all the hospitals, all the water resources, other kind of information that is included. Research or cartography, statistical cartography, produce the and we have on the web two statistics on survival and longevity in Andalusia, which is another one that is on this database. In this case, and we have been linking different sources. In this case, we have been linking the census of 1991, 2001, and 2011. So the data that it has this source is around, we follow around 10 million individuals, and we follow them through time, which is around 3.5 million intermunicipal movements, 9 million presidential changes, around 1.2 million deliveries, and you can have the information and this that you can find here on the web database is around 1 million records. If you want to do in 250 square meter cells. Here on the health or whatever at this level of detail, which is what the Eurostat is, the information on survival and on reproductive biographies, fertility, and you can download as well the information for fertility, female fertility or male fertility, for example, and you have the same kind of information on for cartographical information. Okay. It will appear. So in this case, the kind of things that you can analyze that you cannot do it normally with the data that is produced until now, until recently by the national government. Where you live, by whatever, the combination. To do the combination that you want to. Is, for example, on the effect of the with this kind of data sets, what you can measure is women or low educated women and if you introduce employment of these women a female with educational attainment, what you see is that there is a kind of gradient between. But whenever you introduce relationship with employment, so you are the level of the studies doesn't matter anymore. So what happens if you are an employee or you have a temporary employment, your fertility with the crisis has declined sharply, and the but if you have a permanent job, your fertility has not declined. And what you are just seeing there is the crisis. It's an ITN Marie Curie project. The SIC and the project the project. We have this interest in our heads of to hire 15 Marie Curie registers and this and big data. So we have people like EFRI, which is a GIS company, the main GIS company in the world that produces ArcGIS. We have Telnet, which is mostly interested in big data with electric production and other kind of things. And then we have the Scottish Longitudinal Study that is here with the University of Edinburgh. And then we have other people that I have been showing you before, like Lund and other ones. And it's coordinated from. And we are working on influenza, for example, or we are working on adult health. Or we are working on other aspects, like, for example, the effect of pollution or the environment on mortality and health, or we are looking to heat waves and the effect on health and mortality, and using this kind of data. This is the kind of data that is longitudinal that we follow up individuals and that is geophotic. So this is a kind of broad overview of what we are doing in demography. 2021 census, I organized it with the National Institute of Statistics a meeting in October 2015 on this topic. Everything is on the web and it's open, so you can just see the telephone information on the census. And the National Institute of Statistics decided to do this very open, and I was very thankful for that because and to give comments to what they were planning to do with the census. And also we are organizing with the BBVA Foundation lecture series, and this lecture series, for example, this scholar here, that is Francesco Villari, he has a ERC advanced grant, basically on these topics, on big data and demographic data. In his case, what he's interested in, for example, is in which way internet or high-speed connection is affecting or it will reduce your fertility. I know what you are thinking, so it's not in that way. So the question is, if you have internet at home, quite likely you are working from home, so you can just combine your family and your work life, so probably that could help to increase your fertility. Or probably you have a broadband at your home, or you are just watching series, or what. These kind of things, it can be done with this kind of longitudinal data, and combined with surveys on the use of social media or internet or other kind of characteristics. So it's a kind of combination of things that you do and things that we do in another side that is more related to the morphic. In this area, quite likely we will organize in 2019 a meeting on big data analysis and demography in general in Spain, and I hope just to present in these meetings. So I think that with that I arrive to the 45 minutes, and I think I was just giving you probably a big overview of everything. You can ask yourself why we are doing this historical Madrid and then the recent one of Andalucía. Yeah, and seeing all the overview of the presentation, you data to combine with actual data, and one of the big cities in the world that has. Database in the future, whenever coming, and then the Andalusia in time with historical records as well, just to have a sample to see how well. Is that it will be helpful for us, which I think it will be. And if so, we will try to combine with other kind of information. There is the possibility now in Spain to do that. There are the data sets to be able to, or who knows. Okay, so thank you very much.
Thanks, Diego. Questions? Yeah.
Very fascinating what you can do, and I see also that more and more details get into the information. What about data security into these considerations?
So, is the Institute of Statistics of Andalucía, the one that is status to the National Institute of Statistics. Especially and so the people normally is asking themselves is not an area that is I will not go to the classic example of Google. Especially because you have finished recently the back office is crossing all your data. But I'm very happy that I'm pressing a
the price.
Yeah, with a price. I mean, most of the data linkage profiles, so the curation. in our European
longitudinal studies you show.
Whenever you
20,000 people, you know, each
ones?
Yes,
well, the historical ones, they have a name. And in the pandemic, okay? In pandemic or 2009, the information on mortality or health geography that you have, then you will have you will face. So in that case, so you need to or aggregate the data and hire the instead of per day, per week, or something like that. Statistic as well for some of the production, anonymizing geographically the data. So
diseases and all these things, or not?
Of the historical one. In the all the rest of the things. What we're doing is that the affecting to your fertility intention. And because you have the information on you can just see if you have someone who doesn't have a mother or your sister. So for some of the work that we have been doing, collaborating with for example, on the analysis of basically using Twitter or Facebook or the more or so, just to see the relationship
not electronic data. So having very costly.
Well, I must say that I didn't sponsor were willing to give money. We need to type the data. There was one person on the negotiation. We told them we are going to digitize freely we will give you the metadata of names or names. And then the person said, and what do we win? That is done with they have larger databases and they can do it in a couple of years. They have type 140. Data is provided by the different agencies.
Electronically?
Yeah, for the actual ones. The cost to produce that is, that means that, for example, each doctor has been typing that information in each. Relevant whenever you are just working with these longitudinal studies. To combine and to use the data. Collapse and there is no use. But data to produce the results in a kind of good knowledge on how to organize the hotel. Well, if you have able to link the two individuals that six people over there, six individuals, and with one of the individuals, and then you can have an event from this year to this year is single, and from this year to this year is without the study
to build household. Social security. They work for some companies, or whether they are entrepreneurs.
In Andalusia, you have the census data link. So for the household, you have. Or whatever, you have how many cards. Regarding Social Security, data on disability, for example. I think that they have it from 2011. Able to identify households and the problem that you face if you are looking socioeconomic status of the men. You have for women, especially for elderly women, it would be household is a better marriage. So the proportion of cohabitation now is without marriage or without any kind of from you have complications that just to deal with that. The other another one is you are using administrative who are living outside Spain, that that person is still registered in the padrón, and that it has consequences. If anything happens. We have 20,000 more centenarians. Have bias analysis of health. A kind that is called Salmon bias. Those they will keep on the statistics. Recently, they introduced two changes. If not, they take them away. And they and the bias is to the statistics are due to
what about you were talking about?
No, not in that case. We have data, the actual data that is the tax. Not individual asset by sure, and aggregated.
Well, if there is any other question, the stand.